Hi, in this Excel tutorial, we're going to go over two ways you can pull data from a website into Excel without having to copy it. FYI, for both methods we'll use, you'll want to start with a blank worksheet. Also, keep in mind that this may not work for all websites. It'll depend on the specific site, how it was built, and its settings. In this example, we'll be pulling the list of busiest airports by passenger traffic from Wikipedia. I'll include the URL in the description in case you want to try pulling this data. So the first way we're going to do this is by using the Get External Data option in the Data tab. So when here, simply click on From Web. And for me, the address bar on here automatically defaults to the MSN page, so we'll simply delete that, and I will paste in the URL that I want to pull the data for and click go. So you should see the web page and the URL show up in your window here. Let's make this a bit bigger. And another thing you'll see here is these small arrows. These are flags for areas that we can extract data from. So keep in mind that where these flags are available relate more to the way the site was constructed and not necessarily how it looks. For example, notice that on this page, I have options to pull the entire page here, or if we scroll down, we'll find that my only other option is down here that I can select this table, but it doesn't have any useful data. So we'll go back up and we'll click here where we can get data for the entire page and then click import. So next we need to select the location where the imported data will be placed, and I'm fine with cell A1. But before we click OK, let's click on properties. So here we can set some rules as far as controlling the refreshing of the data when we want that to happen, formatting, and also what to do if the number of rows of data imported should change. So once you're happy with your settings, click OK to import the data from the website. So as you can see from some of these items like the jump to navigation, contents, etc., this pulls all of the data from the section that we selected to pull the data from, which in this case was the entire page. So if you use this method to pull data from a website, you should consider creating another worksheet that you can better format and then link to the data. Because unfortunately, simply removing some of this data and keeping just what we want doesn't help. As you can see here, when I refresh the data, everything repopulated that we had previously deleted. But if you want to scrape everything from a web page or a section of a web page, this would be a good option for you. Also, a quick tip under connections here, consider renaming your connection and/or adding a description for it so you can more easily identify it later. Otherwise, Excel just gives each connection a generic name, and this can get confusing if you have multiple connections. You can also click on Properties here to update those settings if you need to. The next way we're going to pull data from a website is by using Get and Transform, also known as Power Query in some versions. And by the way, if you find this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel for even more tips. So to do this, I'm in Get and Transform, select New Query from Other Sources, and click on From Web. And insert the URL of the website you want to get data from. So in this case, I'm going to use the same URL from before so you can better compare them. Now, the first time you connect to a website this way, you'll need to set your credentials for accessing that site. On future visits, Excel will remember your settings and you should not have to redo this. For our example, I had already selected anonymous, but depending on the site you're pulling from, you may want to sign in using your Windows account, your username and password for a specific website, an API key, or employee credentials if the website is an internal one. And when you're ready, click OK. So as you can see, this option allows you to get data from what Excel identifies as a table in a web page. You can select the ones you want to pull from here from the table view, or you can go to the web view and select from there. If you want to select multiple tables, you can click this box here, and you'll get a little checkbox next to each table that you can select. But I'm going to do it from the table view, and I'm going to start with just 2017. And then when ready, click load. So typically when you do this, the data should auto-populate into your spreadsheet, but if it doesn't, just right-click on it, and we're going to select load to a table in the existing worksheet. And you get your data imported to your spreadsheet in a table format that is very friendly to work with. So the reason I said I was going to start with 2017 is that this can take up a lot of memory in your computer. My little computer, for example, could not handle pulling multiple tables. However, I am able to work around this by creating multiple queries for additional years. So if you come back under data, you'll find the same options for connections, where you can set things like the refresh settings and also the properties, where you can set preferences for what to do if additional data on future refreshes should populate. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on how to extract data from a website into Microsoft Excel. If you did, please make sure to like the video and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks.